Let's look at some key issues in the design of airliners. Okay. First of all, the wing of a transport aircraft or an airliner is subject to a large amount of optimization. Okay. And why is it so? Many people wonder that all airliners, whether they are from Boeing or Airbus, they look very much alike, because both of them have been subjected to the same amount of optimization, similar requirements and similar objectives. So, independently they have come up, the solutions which have arrived from various companies are very similar. There are certain variants of course, and it will be interesting for students to actually be given an exercise to identify totally different approaches and totally different solutions to meet the same requirements. But in transport aircraft of this particular type, you will find most of them have certain common features. What are these features? The wings are swept in most of these cases, but the range in which the quarter chord sweep that you will observe will be between 35 and 38 degrees mostly. Okay. Now, some of them might use supercritical aerofoils, which allow you to obtain the benefits at a lower sweep angle. Okay. And also when you sweep less, you can get more efficient flaps and lower wing weight. So, this is one thing. So, most of the aircraft in this category, airliners which fly near transonic speeds, Mach numbers of around 0.8, they are going to have swept wings with a sweep in a very small band, or supercritical aerofoils allowing it a little bit lesser sweep. The sizing of the fuselage is actually not a very difficult task. So, fuselage is basically going to be almost like a cylindrical body with some nose and some tail. The nose is required to put the cockpit and to put some instrumentation and some features in the front, and the tail is required essentially to accommodate things like the APU, some amount of baggage maybe, and adequate length and taper to conical taper to allow the distancing of the tails, okay, to provide sufficient moment arms. So, the fuselage design is subjected to volume, and for passenger and cargo, whatever is the volume required. And what we want to do is, we want to make it as small as possible to reduce the cruise drag. When you come to the power plant, all of them have generally a high bypass ratio turbofan aircraft, because these give you lower SFCs and lower noise levels, and also lower emissions, especially the NOx emissions, and easy maintenance. Okay. One example I would like to show you, this has been taken again from the book by Professor John Fielding, about how some advanced features have been provided in a transport aircraft to address particular requirements. So, this aircraft, for example, is one of the aircraft which has come with 2-member crew. This is now standard, but when this aircraft appeared in the market, it was one of the first aircraft that came up. Before this, we had aircraft like Boeing 747 older versions, which had a pilot, a co-pilot and a flight test engineer or navigator. So, the cost of the crew has come up because the workload is low. So, you have a low workload cockpit, so you can manage with 2 people, and this was possible by extensive avionics integration. This is an example of how technological developments drive the requirements. Earlier, people were happy to, customers were happy to have the requirement of 3 or 4 people in the cockpit, but now it's only 2. This aircraft has got a center of gravity management system which allows it to fly optimally at various conditions, and there is a flight envelope protection and load alleviation by automatic deflection of the control surfaces to handle the gust loading, And this is possible because of the extended fly-through computer system. On the structure side, the designers have gone for use of new materials and processes, okay, composites and superplastic foaming and diffusion bonding, and also aluminum lithium alloys. On the power plant side, they have been installed with the CFM56 engine, which gives you the, so it's an old engine which was on Airbus A320. It has been enhanced to power the A340. We will come again to this aircraft in the future, because there are certain other additional features that I will discuss. Now let's look at some trends in the design of airliners, especially let's look at families and commonalities. Now, just like we have families in our own personal lives, we also have families in aircraft design. Now, what you do in families is basically you design a baseline aircraft, and then you meet the changing market requirements or provide a competition to an other existing aircraft by stretching or shrinking the aircraft. Okay. So, what do you mean by stretching and shrinking? Basically by inserting and removing the fuselage plugs. You could also do it by changing the engine or by increasing the thrust of the same engine to meet a requirement. And there are many, many examples of this in the Airbus and the Boeing's table, which we will see very shortly. The aim of this exercise is to ensure that every aircraft which the competition makes available, there is an equivalent or similar aircraft in your stable. So, you give the airline a choice that if you want to beat that aircraft in the competition, here is our solution to that particular problem. You can see, for example, if you look at the large twin market, okay, twin engine aircraft, you can see you have, for example, you have 767-200, which was for this particular range and this particular, you know, this particular capacity, and it has been stretched and again, again. Similarly, you know, you have this family. Similarly, you have another family of the Boeing 767 family, where you are just reducing the range by, or I would say the other way, you are increasing the capacity by putting, you know, sorry, you are changing the market requirements. Let's look at this in more detail as we go ahead. Let's look at the Airbus A320 family. This is a very popular family worldwide. It started with Airbus A320, the base aircraft, which came in 1984. Okay. Right? It had approximately, it had 5700 kilometers range, and it has a capacity of around 150 passengers. Then in 1988, 4 years later, the A321 was made available with a larger capacity but a 100 nautical miles smaller range. After that, we had the A319, which was a stretched version as far as the range is concerned, but a shrunk version as far as the capacity is concerned, 6800 nautical kilometers and 124 passengers. This is one way of fighting the long range regional aircraft. And then here is another example of A318, which came in 1995. Here the range was reduced to 6000 kilometers and the capacity was brought down to 107 kilometers. So the same basic aircraft is serving four different markets by using the family concept. Similarly, you have the 777 family chart, where you go from, you know, one aircraft to the other, and then this one to the other, and then there is a kind of a fallout, and there is also a fallout aircraft. So you can see four different markets, I would say five different markets are being addressed. So one aircraft is actually able to handle such a large range of capacity and range. by stretching and shrinking. There are also some commonalities in LNR design, and this is very interesting. Interestingly, you will notice that in the Boeing's table, the Boeing 707 fuselage cross section continues to be used for further aircraft with minimal change. In the case of Airbus, you use the same wing for two aircraft, the twin engine Airbus E330 and 4-engine Airbus 340. They both have almost the same identical wing. This leads to lower manufacturing cost and commonality in service. Okay? And in operation, there are commonalities possible using what is called as a cross Q qualification in the Airbus aircraft. Okay? You can see, for example, here, that, you know, there is a aircraft called A340, all varieties. Within a day, the pilot can convert to flying a 330, and from 330 to A340, it takes just 3 days. Okay. These are large aircraft. Now, if you have a pilot qualified for 340 and 330, and you want that pilot to operate smaller aircraft, it's a matter of just 11 or 15 days, you can convert them. Okay. And then 380s, they are saying, will also have a similar operational advantage. Boeing also allows. Okay. Now, commonality is available only between Boeing 757 and 767. So, from 777 to 787, you can go in 5 days. But notice here, from a non-Boeing aircraft, basically it means an Airbus aircraft, to 787, you require 21 days of training. So, commonality is also there in both the companies. Here is a cockpit or the flight deck of Boeing 787, okay, a very modern cockpit, and a similar configuration you will see now in the future Boeing aircraft. And here is an example of commonality. In fact, if I draw a line here, on the left hand side you have A330, on the right hand side you have A340, one of the versions. Both of them are having a common wing platform. Okay. On one side you see a single engine because it is twin engine, on here you see two engines because it is 4-engine, but they have a common cockpit, they have a common cockpit, common fuselage, common landing gear, common empennage or tail, common systems and common wing. The only difference is in the fuel piping, you know, the piping that will go to the fuel, to the engine here, to the engine here. But for that, it is all common. And from Airbus A340-300 to Airbus A340-200, you just have 8 frames shorter and you get a new aircraft to meet the market. Okay. This commonality does not come without a cost. It is good to have commonality, but here is one assessment by Professor Scott Eberhardt about the drawbacks of commonality. The result is non-optimal design. For example, if you look at the deliveries of Airbus A330 and 340 as compared to 767 and 777, you notice that 330 sold quite well. Any aircraft that sells around 400 units typically just is able to recover its market. This is for a new aircraft, of course. 330, 340 are not new aircraft. But you notice that 767 and 777 have around, as on 2012, they had around 1000 aircraft being sold compared to only around 850 and 400 for 330. So, common wing is good but too heavy and it resulted in the inferior airplane. Okay. Look at the loss in sales. What we saw earlier was lost in numbers. This is a loss in sales. So, compared to 767 and 777, 340s have around $100 billion loss in the sales. And consequently, we notice that there is no new order. So, commonality is good, but commonality can lead to serious financial considerations also.
Thanks a lot.